Alright, Earth. Earth! Actually, just the star map. There we go. And we head back to Earth. Sol! Shit, I really need to do a mineral run between this episode and the next. And here we are, again. A beautiful red planet. Let's see if I can hit this without flying off into the universe. Yes! I'm starting to get a hang of this stupid ship. Hello, Starbase. Shipyard, I think? No, that's just crew. Oh my god, we have no resources. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna scrap one of you guys. I need resources. Scrap. Thank you. Also, Fuifo needs crew. This one needs crew. Exit menu and go to outfit starship. Fuel! You know, I have a feeling I'm never gonna need this gun, so let's get rid of it. It's like, if I ever find myself fighting with my flagship, then I've fucked up somewhere. Now the question is, should I get more ships? I should probably get it. Yeah. I should get more turning jets. They're like 500 each, that's the problem. We can get 4 of them, I think. There we go. That should make us turn a little better. Then we go to shipyard and get ourselves a Hunam cruiser. Earthling cruiser. Yay! And some crew for that thing. There we go. Alright. Now let's go to Commander Hayes.
It's good to see you again, Captain.
Thank you.
There's something I think you should know. Captain, a delegation of Spathi has just arrived here under orders from their High Council to form an alliance and assist you against the Hierarchy. They have provided Fabricator blueprint data for their Eluder spacecraft and promise a steady supply of captains for as many ships as we build. Excellent work, Captain.
Holy crap, they actually did it. That's amazing. Okay, here, have my minerals. Not that I have a lot, but whatever.
Another small load, Captain.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I suppose something is better than nothing.
I know.
Return soon, Captain.
Alright, where's my... There it is. I'm gonna have a look at my paper. And see... Okay, so we've been to Rigel. And we found the Zogfiktbik. We still need to visit those guys, by the way. Even though they live on the other side of the freaking universe. We had someone in Draconis. And I've finally figured out what core word means. Basically, well, I'm gonna go to the map here. Have a look. Star map. Now, core word is apparently the top right corner. So, core word would essentially be this direction. Just right up into this corner. This is core word. That's towards the center of the galaxy. So, in essence, core word from Procyon. We should be able to figure that out pretty easily. So, Procyon is here. And then core word. Yeah, that could be any number of races, like this Spathi or this Zogfiktbik. Procyon. Have we been to Procyon? I don't even remember at this point. I honestly don't even remember if we actually were at Procyon or not. Oh well, whatever. We still can't reach the Zogfiktbik on one tank, which is a little bad, so I suppose we could get rid of one turning jet and get ourselves another fuel tank and fill that up. I don't know. I do not know. But this system here looks very interesting. Now let's see, can I zoom? Yes. This system. I mean, look at it. There has to be something here. It looks really, really interesting. Alpha Vulpecule. On the other hand, there are lots of systems that look very interesting. Like here, for instance, down here, here. Giklas, never mind. Hey! This is Giklas. Well, that has to mean there's something interesting over there. We should probably visit this star, Z-Man, on the way. What are these? Kaeli. Delta, Gamma, whatever. I really want to visit the Zogfit Peak. But it's going to be very difficult. So let's go explore this weird starry thing. Thingamabob stuff. That thing. I have no idea what it is, but let's go. Well, of course the Melnor may have to be here. Alright. Dude, is it an interesting planet? Is that we can look at? Oh, it has a moon. Sweet. I'm going to miss it. Oh, I can actually turn now, though. Does that mean I need my gun back? Alright, what is this? Very hot. I don't think I will survive for many seconds down there. Is that even worth picking up? It's blue, green, and dark blue. Let's have a look. Cargo. Blue, green, and dark blue. Okay, fine. They're kind of valuable, but not. It's not worth dying over. Okay, then this one. Weep. Even hotter and terrible weather and... What? No. 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 Okay, fine. Alpha Vulpecule has absolutely nothing worth taking. And hello, Melnor May. So I suppose... Fine, we'll just go to another system then. I mean, there's plenty of them here. We'll start to the very north, I suppose. Right here. Hi. Hello. I said hello. Yay! Well, there are some planets and they're not scorching hot, so hopefully we can find something here. Oh. I should definitely save. You never know. Save it here. LP underscore 09. Green. Because I have fantasy. Ah, no, no, no! Stop! Thank you. This blue planet. Well, looks healthy. And we can probably pick some of this up. It's not much, but it's something. Hello! I'll take that. Thank you. And there are earthquakes. Ow, balls. I ran straight through that one. Yep, no. Nope. It's like they're trying to get right ahead of me. Really rude. Alright, so takes basically no fuel to go here either, that's good. We lost a lot of crew to that earthquake, that sucks. Hello. Wasn't a lot here, unfortunately. Kinda thought it was more. Oh well. We'll pick this up. And leave! Bye-bye. Well... It's something, at least. I mean, that's better than nothing. Lost 7 crew. Yay. Okay, where was the other one? Oh, further out, okay. Hello. This looks stormy. Yep. No, it's actually not stormy at all. And holy balls, that is nothing! Okay, we're out. Next system. Wait, Epsilon Vulpecule? That's like the last system. Okay, so we'll go the other direction then. This may be the first one. Yeah. Oh well, Alpha is in the middle. Zeta. Okay, this is definitely in the middle. Okay, whatever. We shall have a look at... Really? Come on! Uh-oh. Whoa, what is this? What do you want with me? Oops. Well, I suppose we visit this system instead. I don't even know what that was. Do I want to know what that was? Maybe I do. Maybe they're friendly. Who knows? Oh my gosh. Oh! That is a purple, or pink, or whatever. It's important anyway. Get it and get the hell out, because this planet is blowing up from the inside. Ah! Get out! Wow, three? I thought that was gonna be more. Oh, whatever. Let's go. Somehow I feel I should be going more fast, or faster. That is a gas giant I don't think I can do anything with. Hi. Niet. Nothing. Okay, move along. It's supposed to have moons. Hello. Look at that. More pink. That is good. Pink gives me a lot of stuff. Can we survive on this planet? Hey, give me that. Oh. Ooh, 9. Sweet. Let's take this white before we go to... Actually, this planet isn't too bad. We can probably stay here. Ooh! Alright. I get the picture. I'm out. What a white's worth. Absolutely nothing. Well then. We should probably leave then. We'll go to this pink world over here. Or is it purple? I can't tell. It's... Pinkle. We'll go with that. Some radioactives. Heavy gravity, so it's gonna cost a lot of fuel to land here. Not worth it. Let's go. This looks like a reasonable planet. Hello. It even has a moon. There could be biologicals here. Or... Telluric world. Wow, that's awesome. Please give me minerals. Energy signatures. What? We have to land here. What? Energy signatures? What the balls are these? Xeno historian Kilgore here, sir. We have confirmed that these ruins are the remnants of the Androsynth culture. From the mass destruction we have witnessed, we can only assume that there was some kind of huge land war here within the past 5 years. However, there is no signs of orbital bombardment or invasion from space. Just a whole mess of buildings shot to pieces. Probably the weirdest thing we've seen, or not seen, are corpses. There aren't any. It's as though something appeared out of nowhere, blasted everything with nuclear bazookas, then grabbed all the Androsynth and disappeared. An additional report, sir, from the science officer, Bukowski. We have located an Anderson scientific research station, and I have been trying to make some sense of what is left of their central computer. As far as I can tell, about 7 years ago, the Anderson began experimenting with something they call dimensional fatigue phenomena. I can't figure out what this dimensional fatigue, or as they call it, is, but maybe if we explored another city, I would be able to find more information on the subject. End of report. Okay, let's explore another one then. Bukowski again, sir. We have found another research institute. Well, the ruins of one, anyway. The computer here is in better shape, allowing me to learn a bit more about the Androsynth's investigation into of dimensional fatigue. It would appear that their studies actually began over 10 years ago, after one of their blazer vessels discovered some precursor artifacts in the Alpha Lalande. As far as their scientists here could tell, the devices generated of waves. What the hell? This grammar is off. Which would allow the user to see into other dimensions, realms of existence which share position with our own universe, but have a different, what should I call it, reality phase. Anyway, the Anderson had a hope the dimensional fatigue technology contained in the devices would permit them to create new, faster forms of hyperdrive and hyperwave. Instead, when they began their experiments, they made contact with some kind of life form on the other side. Creatures from the alien dimension. The record is fragmentary here. I see requests to the center computer for information. Data on reality aberrations, the mosquito mange or mange, and ghosts, poltergeists, and other malevolent supernatural creatures. The requests grow more urgent, almost frantic, and then the record ends. Welp? Can we find anything more? Captain, this is Ensign Hawthorne standing in for Bukowski. Sir, Bukowski has found something, but in the process he has gone kind of, well, kind of nuts. When we first got to this city, Bukowski went wild because the science center was pretty much intact. He locked himself in their computer control cabin and spent about 10 hours alone in there. We could hear him mumbling to himself, then his speech got louder until he was shouting. He was scared, sir. Damn scared. We finally decided that we'd better check up on him, but Bukowski wouldn't let us into the room. He said that no one could ever know what he had learned. That just knowing was enough to alert them. He kept talking about them. Crazy stuff, sir. About how they could see him now, and they were moving towards him. Then Bukowski started thrashing around the room, screaming that he had to destroy everything before they saw us too. He did a lot of damage to the Anderson's computer before we stopped him, and I guess he must have hurt himself in the process. He's cut up pretty badly. You know, it's strange. He must have hurt himself worse than I thought. Now when I look at him, it seems like he has even more cuts than just a few minutes ago. And boy, is he screaming. Based on the damage Bukowski wreaked on the central computer, I don't believe that we will find anything more down here. I think we have learned all that we can from the exploring these ruins. And frankly, with all of Bukowski's ranting, I'm getting a bit nervous myself. Call us back to the ship soon, please. End of report. What the actual balls? But it looks like there's something behind these. Oh, there's radioactives.
Nice, gimme.
There's a lot of dead cities here. What are these then? Oh, hello, planet. Amoeba thing. Oh my god, this could take a beating. Get stunned! There we go. Alright, so pick these radioactives up. What was that though? Some kind of cute worm. I will shoot it because that's what I do to ugly xenoforms. 4 biodata, that's nice. I think these only give 1, right? No, 3. Okay, nice. Are these radioactives I'm getting? Thallium, I think that's a radioactive mineral thing, whatever, mubble. There we go, and dude, kill the worm and get more 4 bio, whatever they're called. Oh, hey, there's something alive down here, kill it. Come on, come to Papa. And we leave. Okay, so the Andersons doesn't exist anymore. That's, unpleasant. Let's check the moon. Maybe they moved over here. Lanthanide world. It's a lot of minerals. Not worth balls, though, I think. Let's have a look. Green. I think they're worth basically... Okay, 5. That's not too bad. Balls. I meant to land. Can we go back, please? Oops. Alright. Scan. No! 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 I didn't mean to... Crap! Ow! That is a lot of earthquakes. Oh my... Billy balls. Ah! We should leave. We should leave! Oh my god, how much did it take to land though? Never mind. Alright, so okay. Whew. Let's check this other planet too. So this is where the androsynth were contained, right? Alright. That's interesting. This looks hot. It is not. And there's a lot of living things here too. Let's hope they're not too hostile. I need some bio data. Oh crap, it's those things. Yeah, no, no, leave! I'm sorry, what? Let's get out. Alright, it's time for us to go home. This hurts. Ow. Okay, let's check some more systems. Or maybe these really cold planets out here can have something. I'm just gonna check. I don't feel like farming minerals while you're watching because you're just gonna get bored out of your skull, so I am going to fly away and check more systems, and then I'll do a mineral run while you're not watching. Okay, let's get out of here. There's another planet. I don't care about another planet. Okay, really? Can we stop this now, please? It's not funny anymore. Get me away, please. Get me away! Seriously? Stop it. There we go. Alright. Oh, great. I forgot about you! Oh my god, please don't be something evil. What? I never seen those ships before. What are you?
This is a system message from ship's computer translation subsystem. Incoming message, extremely unusual in composition. Translation includes many lingual anomalies. Overall accuracy of translation is unknown.
Hello, extremely. I hope you like to play. Some campers are not so good for games. Is it time for playing yet?
You aren't kidding, computer. What the hell did he just say? I'm Captain Man of the Starship Valiant. We're having some difficulty translating your messages.
Yes, of course. Difficulty. Problems are difficult. Let's be special together. Spicy games
what?
Are always fun.
Let's be special to get. What the? What are you even saying? You seem like friendly fellows. Perhaps you could aid us in your mission?
Yes, yes. We are too friendly.
You're true friendly.
Extremely okay. Happy sisters should correct each other for celebration. So much enjoyment. Shall we come to your house so that we can be relatives?
I don't know. I presume you're talking about an alliance, so yes, we're very interested. Do we even want to? I don't even know.
Jumping peppers.
Jumping peppers,
this
huh?
This is smiley time.
Uh-huh.
You are campers after all.
Okay.
We will start alliance parties for better enjoyment.
Does that mean we have an alliance now? What the balls was that? No, 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 no! Oh, crap.
Campers
oh, hi.
Like to say hello when they smell the oars. We have learned this. It is no function, but oars want to make campers happy every day. Okay. Hello. Now you are happy, I am sure.
You are the weirdest pieces of lemon I have ever seen. It's good to see you again, I think.
That is funny.
Very funny.
You think you see oars, But ores are not light reflections.
Okay, so you're called the ores. Thank you.
Maybe you think ores are many.
Many bubbles.
Too.
What are you even talking about?
It is such a joke. Ores are not many bubbles like campers.
Ores oh wait.
Are just ores. I am ores. I am one with many fingers.
What?
My fingers reach through into heavy space, and you see ores bubbles, but it is really fingers. Maybe you do not even smell. That is sad. Smelling pretty colors is the best game.
I think I know what you're talking about. So, you said the ores are not light reflections, so you're not actually physical entities. Then you're talking about fingers that reach into heavy space, so you're kind of some form of super-dimensional beings, and what we see are just projections? You also said many bubbles. I assume many bubbles mean atoms, so you're not actually physical. I may be completely wrong about this, but you're still weird, Lemons. Okay, so what happened to the Andersons? You should know that.
I am the best word, Frumple. Maybe you do not know.
What?
Frumple be round yet lumpy. So bad. The asking about Andersons is so Frumple, we are not happy. Do not asking it so much. It is better to not crumple, or else there is so much problems. No more Anderson is better.
Okay, so they don't want us asking about the Anderson. Wait a minute. They said something about them. And they were working with dimensional fatigue to access other dimensions. And then they said that them were really creepy and dangerous and... Are you them? I should probably leave now. I'm
yes,
afraid I must go.
We do. Goodbye is the game. Hello. I am only joke. It is funny enough. Do not forget to enjoy the sauce.
I shall not forget to enjoy the sauce. Goodbye, Ors. What the fuck? Okay, I'm going home. I'm gonna need to have... What the what? Oh, Ors space. So they apparently live there. Okay, that's good to know. And we have returned to the red planet. It should really be the green planet, but whatever. I guess the Ur-Quan wanted it red because it's prettier. Friggin' slave shield. Okay, hello. What? Oh, we have four fuel left. Ahem. Hello, Commander.
Ah, Captain, I'm glad you're back.
Thank you.
Before we go on, I have something important to tell
crap.
You. We've been invaded by an alien race calling themselves the
Oh,
Ors,
shit, no!
Though so far, the invasion is a friendly one.
Okay.
The fish-like creatures have been stomping around the base in their robotic, walking exoskeletons, which look like combat vac suits, if you ask me. Based on the summary reports I've seen on their nemesis ship design, I have but a single comment. I like it. I'd say we have quite a nasty little surprise in store for the Ur-Quan the next time you tangle with them.
Wait, what? Okay. Oh, nice. Resources.
Not a bad job, Captain.
Not a lot either, but...
Be so careful out there,
we
Captain.
Actually got an alliance with these saucy lemon people thing. Okay, let's have a look. Shipyard. So, they said something about Nemesis. Can I actually build their ships? That would be sweet. Earthen cruiser. Oh, Ors Nemesis. Spathia looter. Nice. We have a fair amount of ships now, but I can't afford it. Well, we are going to go to outfit starship and refuel. That was all the resources I had. Alright, we're gonna remove a couple of these turning jets. Actually, I'm gonna have to remove almost all of them in order to get a nemesis, but I think it's gonna be worth it. Of course, I hope so. Shipyard. Fleet. Nemesis. And one crew. Balls. Huh. Maybe we should scrap one more of these. Yeah, there we go. Bye-bye. Alright. There we go. More crew. There we go. Depart Starbase. Nice. Well, I think that is more than enough for one episode. I think this is the longest episode so far. And we're gonna call this LP 10. What the fuck, lemons? Sauce. Right. I'll see you next time. Toodos.